tonight to offer my support and solidarity to the Mayor, Lutfur Rahman, and to everybody else who is campaigning here against this appalling attack on them by Eric Pickles. There's been plenty said about Eric Pickles, but I think we should remember this is a question of democracy. It's a question of people being able to vote and have people carry out policies that they want to carry out. And this is what is frightening the government so much, because the government is promising us another 4 years of austerity, and they do not want a democratic process which says that local people are prepared to put up with those 4 years of austerity. And that is why they have sent in PricewaterhouseCoopers, who are the people who are going to be the commissioners running sections of the council. Now, it seems to me the day when the banks have been fined £2 billion for corruption, for lying, for false dealing, why are we being investigated by a financial company from the City of London? Why aren't we investigating them? That's the way round. But the truth is that every time people like Lutfur have stood up for ordinary people, they have been surcharged, they have had commissioners, they have been driven from office by people who themselves have absolutely no respect for democracy or for the truth. If we were really serious about democracy in this country, why haven't we done something to a war criminal which took us to a war illegally on the basis of lies and millions of pounds? Why haven't we taken people to court for the privatisations that they have illegally indulged in? Why haven't we taken them to court for the PFI, which means our children and our children's children will be paying for schools and hospitals for the next generation to come? Those are the questions that we need to ask. But there's another question here in Tower Hamlets, and we shouldn't pretend that there isn't. There is a question of racism here as well. They're trying to say two things. They're saying, firstly, that this is the kind of thing that happens in places like Tower Hamlets, that there's more corruption than there is in other places. That is a complete lie. And coming from the parliamentarians who fiddled their expenses and then shredded the documents afterwards so we can't even revert back to them, it is an absolute travesty that they are trying to make us do. But it's also about the Muslim community. We had the investigation into the Birmingham schools, which was a complete farrago of lies and innuendo and turned out to be completely untrue. Trying to do to the Muslim community here. We have had a war going on now for 13 years. We said 13 years ago it would create racism and attacks on civil liberties and Islamophobia. That is what is happening now, and we have to stand up against it. The Muslim community in this country has been the most involved, the most political, the most prepared to go out on the streets against war in support of Palestinians and against racism, and we will stand with them in every way that they do that. I'd like to propose, of the many things that come out tonight, I hope that we can get together a conference here in Tower Hamlets on Islamophobia, where we get Muslims and non-Muslims, and we say we are rejecting the agenda of UKIP and the racism. That is what is important for us to do. So stand together, let us unite and fight campaign in defence of the council here, in defence of the mayor, but also in defence of some of the poorest people in this country. It is grotesque that we live in a place like this where half a mile down the road there are office blocks which are selling, as the Gherkin did this week,